present. My ERT topic, my topic head is language learning strategies. Language learning strategies can be classified as a conscious mental activity. They must contain not only an action, but goal or an intention and a learning situation. Whereas a mental action might be subconscious, an action with a goal, intention and related to learning situation can only be conscious. So learning language strategy is a deliberate and goal-direct attempt to control and manage effort to when we learn our second or foreign language. This is a definition by given by researchers of language learning strategies by John Rubin. Any language learning strategies is any sets of operations, steps, plans, routines used by the learners to facilitate the obtaining, storage, retrieval and use of information. And by Rebecca Oxford, language learning strategies is specific actions, behaviors, steps or techniques that students often intentionally used to improve their progress and development skills. So language learning strategies can be defined as our course, our progress, goal, methods and actions that we use to complete our learning tasks. Classification of LLS. Language learning strategies also classified by skill areas, and this classification of a skill is also include receptive and productive skills like receptive skills like listening and reading, and productive skills like writing and speaking. So language learning strategies, based on the various perspective about defining learning strategies, it can be inferred that language learning strategies can be divided into different categories. In fact, language learning strategies have been categorized by many researchers and experts since the 70s, by Neyman, by Rubin, by Brown and Perlinskar, by O'Malley and Chamot. This is the classification of language learning strategies. Language learning strategies is divided into two main classes, direct analysis and indirect analysis. Direct is required when mental processing of the language, and indirect strategies is learning without directly involving target language. This is the subdivision of language learning strategies. They are divided into two, direct and indirect strategies. In direct strategies, there are three: memory, cognitive and compassion. And in indirect strategies, there are three groups of language learning strategies, that metacognitive strategies, affective strategies and social strategies. And there are also sub-category group of these old strategies, like creating mental links, practicing, dressing intelligently, centering your learning, lowering your anxiety and asking questions. First of all, cognitive strategies. Cognitive strategies include what learners think, such as reading for purpose or reading for identifying rules about their own learning. So cognitive strategies is a direct strategy, and cognitive strategies is also used for the recalling and understanding and new information. And in cognitive strategies, this step is used to help into learning and problem solving, indirect analysis, like clarification, verification, guessing, inductive inference, deductive reasoning, memorizing, and monitoring. Next, metacognitive strategies. Metacognitive strategies talk about the strategies such as observing on mistake and improving on that, or planning and following a good timetable and learners employ in their process. Metacognitive strategies is indirect strategies, and in metacognitive strategies help students to regulate their own cognition, and also help students to focus and plan and evaluate their own progress. And in metacognitive strategies is necessary to arranging and planning learning and also evaluating your learning. Next, memory strategies. Memory strategies show how, such as using flashcard or reviewing lessons, learners remember the language. According to Purpura 1997, memory strategies are frequently employed for memorizing vocabulary and structures in the early phase of language learning. So memory strategies also help students to restore and reading new information. And memory strategies are more effective when it using in conjunction with affective strategies and metacognitive strategies. And in memory strategies, there are three subcategories, like applying images and sounds, reviewing waves and employing actions. Next, social strategies. Social strategies involve the strategy that learners use or the interaction they do to facilitate their own learning, such as asking for corrections from proficient speakers or learning the native cultures, etc. So, social strategies is a provide increasing. And in social strategies activity, where learners also expose themselves and also have opportunity to show in their knowledge and practicing and using and storing and containing their internet in the language. And social strategies is also focused on the practicing in the conversation also. And social strategies also help to foreign language learners to learn interact with others. And in social strategies, it's necessary to cooperating with others and empathizing with others. Compensation strategies. Compensation strategies are related to what learners do, such as making guesses or finding alternative ideas, etc. to compensate their limited knowledge in the language. So, compensation strategies is aid students to overcome their knowledge gaps and also helps to continuing rotating the process and also helps in the communication. And so compensation strategies is overcoming our limitations and also helping to speaking and writing. Last, affective strategies. Affective strategies talk about learners' feeling as well as what they do to motivate themselves and to make the learning process comfortable, such as relaxing when they feel afraid of the new language or rewarding themselves when they perform well, etc. So, affective strategies also helping learners to give them emotion and also help and regulate to motivate, to progress and make motivation, attitude and emotion. And affective strategies is also developing our self-confidence and also performance needed for the students to actively involve in the language. And so affective strategies is encourage ourselves and also talking and it is necessary in affective strategies to talk in your emotional temperature. In a strategies is very necessary to teacher should help students to encourage and cultivate their awareness towards language learning progress by using these language learning strategies. And and student also should be aware that they would be skillful and also facilitated these strategies in using their language learning process by using LLC. So researchers tend to agree that teachers preparation for strategy instruct is enhanced by using an experimental approach that enables teachers to discover their own strategies and consider the new ones and learn how to model and teach them. Thank you.